الرحمن الرحيم. الحمد لله وصلى الله وسلم على نبينا محمد وعلى آله وصحبه وسلم ما بعد. So many people of innovation from Ahl al-Bid'ah wal Ahwa, the people of desires and innovation, they predict, they plan, they plot, they attack Ahl al-Sunnati wal Jama'ah. How many people and how many websites have we seen, people like Omar Lee, people like the Rafida, people like the some of the Takfiris, and many other Hizbis or groups that adhere to various Jama'at or various groups and sects, as the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam made clear for us that the Ummah would break into, and that this is something which is undesirable, this is something sinful and something wicked. As Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says, وَاعْتَصِمُوا بِحَبْلِ اللَّهِ جَمِيعًا وَلَا تَفَرَّقُوا. Allah tabaraka wa ta'ala orders us to hold on, all of you together, to the rope of Allah, and do not divide. And the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam said, لَا تَزَلْ طَائِفَةٌ مِنْ أُمَّتِي ظَاهِرِينَ لَلْحَقِّ حَتَّى يَأْتِيهُمْ أَمْرَ اللَّهِ وهم على ذلك. وكما قال النبي صلى الله عليه وعلى آله وسلم, the Prophet صلوات ربي وسلامه عليه said, there won't cease to be a group from amongst my nation that is on the truth, and that and they will continue to be upon it until the day to the hour. So this shows us that Ahl Sunnah will always be around, and regardless if people claim and have hatred for Ahl Sunnah, and they make claims like the end of the Salafi Dawah, or the end of the Salafi this, or the Salafis are soon coming to an end, and all kind of really ridiculous claims, because Ahl Sunnah is always going to be mawjood. Ahl Sunnah is always going to be present, and this is a promise from Muhammad ibn Abdullah sallallahu alayhi wa alihi wa sallam, when he said, لَا زَلْ طَائِفَةٌ مِّنْ أُمَّتِي ظَاهِرِينَ الْحَقِّ حَتَّى يَأْتِيهُمْ أَمْرُ اللَّهِ وَهُمْ ظَاهِرُونَ. وَكَمَا قَالَ النَّبِي صَلَّى اللَّهُ عَلَيْهِ وَسَلَّمَ فِي رُوَايَةٍ أُخْرَى, لَا تَزَلْ طَائِفَةٌ مِّنْ أُمَّتِي ظَاهِرِينَ لِلْحَقِّ لَا يَضُرُّهُمْ وَلَا مَنْ خَالَفَهُمْ وَلَا مَنْ خَذَلَهُمْ حَتَّى تَقُومَ السَّاعَةُ. That the there won't cease to be a nation from my community, meaning the Ummah of Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, that continues to be on the truth. No one can harm them, even if they differ with them and dispute with them, until the hour will be established. So this is the case. It doesn't matter with people claiming this and claiming that. How many more people know about the Dawah to Ahl Sunnah in this day and age? It's becoming so widespread that there's so many more people who are trying to adhere to the Sunnah of Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wa alihi wasallam, with the understanding of the companions radiyallahu ta'ala anhum ajma'in. This is the case. So it really doesn't matter what the claimants say. Never be disheartened by that, nor taunt people even if they differ, but rather seek knowledge. Seek ilm nafiyah, beneficial knowledge, and spread that knowledge. And that will hurt Ahl al-Bid'ah and Ahwa more than wasting time in vain debates. The more you seek knowledge, the more you spread that beneficial knowledge, the more you offer the people the clean cup of water, the Ahl al-Sunnati wal Jama'ah, that they hold on to the rope of Allah, which is the Quran and the Sunnah of the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam, and the understanding of the companions radiyallahu ta'ala anhum ajma'in, and that they are united based on Kitab wa Sunnah, and that they are beautiful in their conduct based on Kitab wa Sunnah, and that their fiqh, their understanding, their jurisprudence is based on Kitab Allah wa Sunnah to Rasul sallallahu alayhi wa sallam wa fahim as-salaf as-salih radiyallahu ta'ala ajma'in. The more that we show that example, the less those people, the people of desires, the people of innovation, will have to criticize. They can continue to attack, but it will have no benefit. And rest assured of that. And this is the case, and this is the sunnah of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala that He has created, that and destined that the ummah would divide. As the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam said, افترقت اليهود على 72 فرقة وافترقت النصارى على 72 فرقة وستفترق هذه أمة على 73 فرقة كلها في النار الواحدة. قلنا من هي يا رسول الله؟ قال من كان على مثل ما كان عليه وأصحابي اليوم. The Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam said, which affirms for us that our community, the community of Muslims, would break and divide, and that those who deviate from the sunnah of the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam and that of his companions radiyallahu ta'ala anhum ajma'in would be misguided. Because the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam said the Jews will break into 71 sects, and the Christians in 72 sects, and my ummah the 73 sects, all of them in the fire except one. And they said, who are they, Ya Rasulullah sallallahu alaihi wasallam? He said, those who are upon what I'm upon and what my companions are upon. And this shows us that the ummah would break and divide and split, but that a group from amongst him, as the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam said, لا تزال طائفة من أمتي دارين الحق, that a group from amongst him would remain on the truth, and that no one could harm them. And those are the ones that who? They follow the sunnah of the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam. They hold on to the rope of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, which is the Quran and the Sunnah of the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam, and the understanding of the Salaf al-Salih. They follow the Salaf al-Salih, radiyallahu ta'ala anhum ajma'in. And the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam said, "Ittaqullah wa sim'i wa ta'a, wa in 'abdin habashiyan, fa innahu man ya'ish minkum fasira ikhtilafan kathira." فعليكم بسنتي وسنة الخلفاء الراشدين المهديين عضوا عليها بالنواذج وإياكم ومحدثات الأمور فإن كل بدعة ضلالة. The Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam said, letting us know that we would divide and that there's a prescription for this division, that there's a medicine, there's a way out. He said, اتقوا الله وسمعوا الطاعة. He said, fear Allah and listen and obey. Listen and obey who? To the Muslim ruler. اتقوا الله وسمعوا الطاعة. وإن عبد حبشيا, even if it was an Ethiopian slave. ومن يعيش منكم فسيرى اختلافا كثيرا. ومن يعيش منكم من بعدي فسيرى اختلافا كثيرا. So whoever lives after my time will see many differences. And this is the case. It was during the time of the end of the Sahaba, radiallahu ta'ala anhu, the Asr of Sahaba, the time when the Sahaba were present, is when a lot of these groups began, beginning with the Khawarij, then the Shia, you know, min Abdullah ibn Saba, then the Qadariya. The Qadariya was during the time of the Tabi'een and Akhra Asr al-Sahaba, radiallahu ta'ala anhum ajma'in. And then we had the Jahmiya. And then we had, you know, all the way and up until we had the Ash'ariyah, who are a little bit later after the Mu'tazila and so forth, and evolved from them. So we were aware that the ummah would split. But what did the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam said? He said, فَسَيْرَا اخْتَلَافٍ كَثِيرًا, that you will see many differences. فَعَلَيْكُمْ بِسُنَّتِي وَسُنَّةَ الْخُلَفَاءِ الرَّاشِدِينَ, and is upon you my sunnah, and that of the rightly guided Khalifa, meaning Abu Bakr, wa Umar, wa Uthman, wa Ali, radiallahu ta'ala anhum ajma'in. And we ask Allah the Almighty to bless us to follow that prophetic advice and bless the ummah to be one based on the kitab wa sunnah of the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam and that of his companions radiyallahu ta'ala anhum ajma'in. Wa sallallahu wa sallam ala nabiyyina Muhammad wa ala alihi wa sahbihi wa sallam.